Pleasant afternoon, everybody. The best time recording is already on progress. Allow TIS and allow teacher Jermaine to record our session this afternoon. Okay, I guess everybody is ready for our discussion. It's just like what I said, after the discussion, later on, teacher will be giving a short test. Okay. So we will be continuing with our discussion on grammar. So we will be using the blue book again. I hope you have a copy of the blue book. If not, you can just read through my screen. So I hope everybody is doing good. Allow me to start. Allow me first to start sharing my screen. Let's have a review first. Okay, please notify me if you can already see my screen. Clara, can you see teacher's screen?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, with that, Clara, I want you to read rule number one, just a sort of review. For a while. Here. Okay, please read rule number one, Clara.
Rule one. If a verb follows to, it is called an infinitive phrase and is not the main verb. You will find the main verb either before or after the infinitive phrase.
Okay, so that is that's the first rule that we discuss. A verb that is being followed by to, okay, you call that one as infinitive. So where can you find the verb in that one? And find it either before or after the infinitive phrase. For example, okay, the given example is I like to walk. I like to walk. When you say infinitive phrase, that is to. Oh, the infinitive phrase is to walk. So where's the verb? It is before the infinitive phrase. Our verb here is like. Okay. Another example given, the efforts to get her elected succeeded.
Miss, sorry, Miss, I'm late to join the Zoom.
It's okay, Grace. It's okay.
Okay.
Teacher just started the discussion. Okay, another example here. The efforts to get her elected succeeded. Okay, the infinitive phrase here is to get her elected. Where can we find the verb? It is after the infinitive phrase. Our verb here is succeeded. We also have the definition of subject. Is it raining in Indonesia now? Is it raining?
No, miss.
My
yes.
It's raining.
It's raining, miss.
It's raining, Miss Germaine.
Also here in my place, it's also raining. Yeah, it's also raining here in my place. Okay, so we also discuss about subject in the sentence. So you have it here. A subject is the noun or pronoun that performs the verb. Okay, the doer of the action, that is the subject. Okay, the woman hurried. Our subject is woman. Our verb here is hurried. So that's very easy. Okay, that's very easy to understand. Okay, I will highlight the next rule. Okay, Mark, could you please read rule number three, Mark?
Okay. Rule number three. To find the subject and verb, always find the verb first. Then ask who or what performed the verb.
Yes. Okay. So you are going to analyze, you're going to read and analyze the sentence for you to identify what is the subject in that, what is the subject as well as the verb in that sentence. Rule number three goes along, okay, with all of the rules here on grammar. Please take note that the verb must agree with your subject. So if the subject is singular, the verb should be plural? Yes or no? The subject is singular. Should the verb be plural?
No, miss.
Of course, it's a no because it should also be a singular verb. So if your subject is plural, what kind of verb should we have? Again?
Singular verb.
Okay, it should have a plural verb. So please take note, identify the subject so that you can clearly use the correct verb in a sentence. Okay, I'll give you examples later on before we continue. Before we continue with other rules and grammar. Okay, very good. I have 19 participants now. Let's move now. Okay, let's have this one. Josephine, can you please read rule number four?
Okay, Miss. Rule four. Any request or commands such as stop or walk quickly has the understood subject you, because if we ask who is to stop or walk quickly, the answer must be you.
Very good. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Josephine.
You're welcome, Miss.
Inda, could you read again rule number four?
Okay. Any request or command such as stop or walk quickly has the understood subject you, because if we ask who is to stop or walk quickly, the answer must be you.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
So please take note, if you have imperative sentence, because mostly imperative sentence does not directly contain the subject in the sentence. So if you have this, please bring me some coffee. It is understood that the subject in the sentence is, what's the subject? It is you. Okay, so take note, it has to be understood that the subject or the doer of the action is you. Okay, can I ask Inda to please read my message in the chat box?
Okay, miss. Swipe the floor now.
Okay. It is an example of an imperative sentence. Swipe the floor now. There is no, the subject is not directly given, but it is understood that the subject is, what's the subject, Inda?
You.
Yes, it is understood that the subject is you. How do you spell you? And that?
Y-O-U.
Okay, very good. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, Okay, I am writing another sentence in the chat box. Okay, how about Farrell?
What, miss?
Okay, I have another sentence in the chat box, Farrell.
Study your lesson daily.
Okay, study your lessons daily. There is no, what do you call that one? No subject given directly, but what is our subject? What do you think is the subject now? It is understood that the subject is study your lessons daily. It is understood that the subject in the sentence is yes, the subject is you. How do you spell you, Farrell? How do you spell you?
Y-O-U.
Okay, very good. Thank you, Farrell. Okay, please, again. Okay, everybody take note of that one. Imperatives doesn't give you the subject, but it is understood that the subject is you. I'll stop sharing my screen first. Oh, the rain is very, what do you call that one? It's very heavy.
The rain is very heavy?
Yeah, it's heavy. It pours heavily. It's pouring heavily. Can you hear the sound of the rain? Or no?
No. I can't, but apparently in my location it is thundering.
So, I'll be sharing again, but I'll not be using the blue book. Mark, can I have you, Mark?
Okay.
Okay, please read the sentences.
Subject verb agreement. The girl jumps rope at Rex's. The girls jump rope at Rex's.
Okay. Anybody of you who can tell me what's the difference between the two sentences?
The first sentence is singular.
Who is this? Is this Alfonso?
The first sentence is singular.
Okay, for a while. Yes, Alfonso.
The first sentence, the subject and the verb is singular. Then the second sentence is singular, are plural.
Yes, you have plural subject. Of course, the verb should also be plural. Okay, that's a good observation, Alfonso. Okay, this time, can I ask Honey?
Yes, miss.
So we have this sentence, Honey, and everybody. The girl jumps rope at recess. Alfonso said that the subject is singular. What's the subject in the sentence?
Girl.
Very good. And what's the verb, Honey? What's the verb?
Rope, yeah. Huh? The girl jumps rope at jumps.
Yep.
Hey, honey, you are correct. Our subject is girl. What's the verb in the sentence? What's the verb? The action word.
Jumps.
Yeah, with letter S, honey. With letter S, jumps.
Jumps.
Very good. Thank you, honey.
Yes.
How about Sundara? Sundara?
Yes, miss.
Okay, Sundara, the second sentence. The girls jump rope at your set. Okay, please read.
The girls jumps rope at Rattles.
Yes. What's the subject, Sundara?
Girl.
With letter S. Girls.
Girls.
Very good. That's a plural subject. What's the verb now? What's the verb?
Jumps.
Okay, our verb here is jump.
Jump.
Okay, very good. Okay, thank you, Sundara.
Thank you, me. Thank you, me.
Okay, so that's what you need to take note, okay? Identify the subject so that you can use the correct verb in the sentence. So I guess I don't have to give more examples of that one. Let's move now to other rules. Of course, sentence number five. Okay, because you have here, sentences often have more than one subject, more than one verb or pairs of subjects and verbs. So that just what I keep on saying, identify the subject so that you can identify also the correct verb. Okay. I guess you have finished discussing this with other teachers. Alfonso?
Yes, miss.
Do you already reach this point with other teachers?
It's already passed.
Oh, so I guess all of you understood it.
Yes.
Wow, that's good. Okay, so I guess teacher needs to maybe read it. Not me, but okay. But I'll be asking kids to read it. Okay, I guess this one will be very easy. Okay, Justin, please read rule number one.
What, miss?
For a while.
Okay. Two singular subject connected by or nor require a singular verb. Example, my aunt or my uncle is arriving by train today.
So what is being connected by or nor? What is being connected by or nor? You have? What does rule number one says?
Two singular subjects connected by or nor require a singular verb.
Okay, you have two singular subjects. Please read the example, Tristan, again.
Example, my aunt or my uncle is arriving by train today.
Could you please give me the two singular subjects?
Aunt and uncle.
Okay, so what... What is the verb in the sentence, Tristan?
Arriving.
Is it arriving only?
Is arriving.
Yeah, is arriving. Why is the verb is arriving? Why is it is arriving?
Because one of them is going to the train.
My teacher's question is, why should we use is arriving, not are arriving? Why is arriving? Other kids can also answer, by the way. Why should we answer is arriving? Why not my aunt or my uncle are arriving by train today? It's because why? Anybody? Since other teachers have already discussed this rule?
Maybe I can.
Yes, Mar.
I think it means, for example, my aunt or my uncle is arriving by train today. Normally, it was supposed to be are. But in this case, this just singular subject, my aunt and my uncle are the two singular subject, and it's connected by or. And it requires singular verb. So I think the word is the singular verb, because we think that my aunt or my uncle is kind of like a one subject. Is that right?
Okay, exactly. Okay, thank you, Mark, for that very good answer. That's very good of you, Mark. Okay, our verb is arriving, because the rule says, oh, you go back to the rule, and please understand what the rule is. So when you have two singular subjects being connected by or nor, automatically the subject should be singular. So I am asking, why is it is arriving? It's because that's the English rule. That's the rule for grammar. Two singular subjects connected by or nor, it should have a singular verb. Okay, later on, I'll be giving examples for that one. Okay, let's move now to rule number two. Thank you so much, Mark, and thank you, Tristan. Okay, let's move to rule number two. Rule number two, can I have Mariana to read?
Two singular subjects connected by either or neither nor require a singular verb as in rule one.
Okay, so either or neither nor, just like rule number one, it should have a singular verb. Okay, let's have the first example. Can I have Mariana? Mariana again for the second example. First example.
Examples. Neither Juan nor Carmen is available.
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 Can you read it again, Mariana?
Available.
The sentence, please.
Neither Juan nor Carmen is available.
Okay. In this sentence, look at this, everybody. In this sentence, you have the word neither paired with nor. So if you use neither nor in a sentence, our verb should be singular. What is the verb in the sentence? Neither Juan or nor Carmen is available. What's the verb in the sentence? What's the verb in the sentence?
Is available.
Our verb here is is. Our verb is. Neither Juan nor Carmen is available. Our verb here is. Why is? Because Juan, Carmen, the subjects in the sentence are connected by neither nor. Okay, let's move to the next one. Okay, I'll be asking Shitya to read. Shitya?
Yes, miss.
Read the second example, please.
I thought Kiana or Casey is helping today with stage decoration.
Come again, please read it again.
I thought Kiana or Casey is helping today with stage decoration.
Very good. It's either Kiana or Cassie is helping today with stage decorations. So two singular subjects. Our first subject is Kiana. We also have the second one, which is Cassie. Okay, it is connected by either or. So our verb here is helping. Why is the verb is helping? Why is the verb is helping? It's because there are two singular subjects being connected by either or. Because the rule says, if you have either or neither nor, the verb should be in singular form. Okay. Let's move now to rule number three. Can I ask Aaron to read rule number three?
Rule three. When I is one of the two subjects connected by either or neither nor, put it second and follow it with the singular verb I'm.
Okay. Thank you, Aaron.
Thank you, Miss.
Okay. I would also like to ask Claudine to read rule number three. Claudie. Claudie can hear me. Okay, if not, Claudie, Alfonso, could you please read rule number three, Alfonso?
Hey, miss. When I is one of the two subjects connected by either or neither nor, put it second and follow it with the singular verb am.
Please read the example.
Example. Neither she or nor I am going to festival. To the festival.
So you have here. So you have it here. So when you have two subjects, and the first one of the two subjects you have I, okay, you are going to put it on the second one, then the singular verb you're going to use am. Okay, so you say neither she nor I. So the correct way of writing or putting it, you won't say neither I nor she. But you start first with the first given subject, put I at the second, then you put am going, okay, or am eating, or other verbs. So that is rule number three. Okay, when you have two subjects, the other one is I, you put it second and follow it with the singular verb am. Okay, let's move to rule number four. Okay, rule number four, how about Ressa?
Yes, Miss.
Okay, please. Wow, your microphone is already working now.
Yes, Miss.
Okay. Okay. Please read rule number four.
Okay, Miss. When a singular subject is quoted by or nor to a plural subject, put the plural subject last and use a plural verb.
When a singular, okay, thank you, Ressa.
You're welcome, Miss.
Okay, I'll be reading it. When a singular subject is connected by or nor to a plural subject, okay, put the plural subject last and use a plural verb. Okay, this, okay, you have here, the serving bowl or the plates go to that shelf. Okay, basically, when you have this one, the nearer subject is plates. Of course, that is plural. So the verb should also be plural. Okay? I'll stop sharing my screen. Then I'll be sharing another one because I'll be giving examples. I hope I am already sharing my screen. I would like to talk to Audrey. Audrey, hello. Oh, how about Felicia?
Yes, hello, Miss.
Okay, could you please read the example, the given sentence?
Neither Alfonso nor Noel is ready for the examination.
Okay. Do you think we have one or two subjects in the sentence?
We have two subjects.
Yes, we have two subjects. And it is being connected by
neither nor.
And what kind of verb are we going to use?
Is ready.
Okay, so you have here is ready. Is this sentence correct, Felicia?
Yes.
This sentence is correct. Grammatically correct. Okay, thank you, Felicia.
Yes, you're welcome, Miss.
I have here another example. Okay. I have here another example. Noel, could you please read this?
Either Felicia or Audrey is are available.
What should be the correct verb? Is it is or are?
Are.
Either Felicia or Audrey are available?
Oh, okay, no, is.
Please be sure. Either. But the answer, it is? The correct answer is. Either Felicia or Audrey is available. Why should we answer is? What should be our answer is? It's because we have two singular subjects. Our two singular subjects are Felicia and Audrey, being connected by either or. The rule says you are going to use a singular subject. Okay, everybody, again, either Felicia or Audrey is available. Our subject should be is available. Why? Because the rule says when you have two singular subjects connected by either or, you are going to use a singular verb. Okay. Please do not forget about that rule. Okay? I hope I am not too fast for everybody. Okay, I have here another sentence. I would like to talk to Nicolas.
Yes, miss.
Are you okay?
Yes, I'm okay, miss.
Please read now this one.
Neither Vanessa nor Josephine likes cake.
Yes. What verb are we going to use for that? Is it like or likes?
Likes.
Very good. Okay. The correct verb to be used here is likes. Okay. Thank you, Nicolas. Very good.
Welcome, miss.
Okay. Why? So when you have likes, this is a singular verb. Again, this is a singular verb. Why should our verb be singular? Because we have two singular subjects, Vanessa, Josephine, connected by neither nor. Our subject should be in singular form. So you have neither Vanessa nor Josephine likes. Okay. How about if we have a plural subject? Okay. For example, okay, we have this sentence here. Okay, Zelda, Maybe you want to read Zelda. Okay, if not, Josephine, can I have you again, Josephine?
Neither Farrell nor the boys is hard to look down.
Okay, come again.
Neither Farrell nor the boys is hard to look down.
Okay, very good. Okay, neither Farrell nor the boys is hard to look down. Okay, in this sentence, you can say that we have two subjects. We have Farrell. We also have here boys, connected by neither nor. When you say Farrell, that's singular. But when you say boys, that's already plural. So what should be our verb? Is it is or are? Okay, take note, boys, that is plural. So what should be the verb? Is it is or are? Is or are?
Is?
Should we
are?
Yes. We are not going to use is, but we are going to use are. Because our subject, our second subject, boys, it's plural. So our verb should be plural. That's not this case, this sentence is not like the first sentence here, because we have two singular subjects. But in this one, we have one singular and we have one plural. Thus, the verb should be in plural form. Okay? Thank you, Josephine.
You're welcome, Miss.
Albie. Okay, Alfonso, can I have you to read the sentence, please?
Okay, miss. Either the teacher or the kid eats lunch at the cafe.
Read it again, please.
Either the teacher or the kid eats lunch at the cafe.
Okay. Please analyze the sentence. Should we use it or it's?
It.
Could you please read it now?
Either the teacher or the kids eat lunch at the cafe.
Why should we answer it, Alfonso?
Because the second subject is plural.
Yes, that's very good. Thank you, Alfonso.
You're welcome.
Okay, that's very good. Okay. Look at Alfonso. He's very good. Because the second subject, you have kids. That's plural. So the verb is also in plural form. But if you say this one, either the teacher or the kid. When you say kid, that's singular. So your verb should be it's. Okay. Either the teacher or the kid, it's lunch at the cafe, because you both have singular subjects. Okay, but if you say here, either the teacher or the kids, the verb should be plural. Eat lunch at the cafe. Okay, so I hope with our discussion this evening, you have somehow recalled the discussion also made by other teachers here in TIS. So, it's already 5:53. So, basically, it's not a short discussion because we almost consumed all our time. I will be sending the link here for the test. I want you to do it.
Wait, so today is the exam?
Yes, today. I will not be sending the link in the WhatsApp. I will only be sending it here because so that I can get the attendance for today. Because if I'm sending it in the WhatsApp, the other kids who are not here can also answer. So that it will be fair for everybody. Please check the chat box. The link for the test is already there. I hope you can finish it on time because you still have a next class with another teacher. But if not, you can still continue it afterwards. Okay, kids, it's almost time. But you need I am not closing the link for the test because I'll be giving you time. I know you still have a class after this one. Okay, so okay, please find time in answering the test, okay? Thank you everybody for joining me in our discussion this afternoon. Please find time in answering the test this afternoon, okay? Okay, your next teacher is already here.